Brothers and sisters, first of all, the most important thing to focus on in your day is your fard prayers, the compulsory acts, the compulsory worship that Allah has told us about. Your fajr, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha. Make them the best that you can. And they're not very long, so make them the best that you can. And there's a beautiful hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, which is in Bukhari and Muslim. It's called the Hadith Qudsi, which means that the Prophet, peace be upon him, is talking on behalf of Allah. And Allah said, there is nothing that my servant comes closer to me better than the things which I have made compulsory upon them. So this is the best way of getting close to Allah. Secondly, a lot of people neglect the idea of being good to each other as a family at home, when the spouses help each other, when the children help their parents and the parents help their children. In the home, just your normal chores, the cooking, the cleaning, the sometimes even spending good quality playful time together, teaching each other, going out into the garden together, doing all these things. So long as you can make that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is a form of charity from you and a good deed that Allah will not make lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّن خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Whatever you put forth for yourselves, you will find its reward with Allah. هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا. Allah has the best reward and He has the most magnificent and greatest. In other words, when you do something for the sake of Allah, it means that you should not be doing it expecting a reward or thanks from that person you did the good for. If you're doing it for the sake of Allah, wanting the reward from Allah, it means that whether that person thanks you or rewards you or not, you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has still got the reward for you, and we don't remind the other person. But if the other person thanks us, then they're good people. And if they reward us, they're good people, and we should appreciate that. So my brothers and sisters, that way you turn everything you do in your house as worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nothing is rendered lost. Number three, is there's a special prayer called Salat al-Duha. It's neglected by a lot of people, but it's a great sunnah from the Prophet, peace be upon him. Listen to this beautiful statement of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is in Sahih Muslim. He said, every morning when a believer wakes up, then for every body and joint in their body, they have to give a charity, a good deed. And he said, saying Subhanallah or Alhamdulillah or Allahu Akbar is all a good deed. He said, advising someone to do something good or advising them to stay away from something bad is a form of good deed. And then he said, two rak'ahs of duha that you pray will cover all the bones of your body and your joints. The bones and body and joints of your body are things which Allah had given us to use in worship and in blessings and to serve ourselves and others. So in return, we use them to be grateful and give. And that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sees the good deed and rewards for it. Salat al-duha is basically a two rak'ah prayer that you pray any time between 15 minutes just after sunrise up to about 15 minutes before dhuhr, any time in that time. And now brings me to the most important part of Ramadan, and that is Taraweeh. What is Taraweeh? Taraweeh is just another name for night prayer. And night prayer is a highly virtuous act. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it in the Quran, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do it every single night, and he advised us to do it. In there is a sweetness. Now, we can't pray Taraweeh in the masjid, and we have to pray it at home. There are some people who have been asking me, I don't know how to recite the Quran, how? And I'm alone, some of them have converted to Islam and they can't recite and they don't have anyone to lead them. And I've been asked a lot of questions. So here's a few options that I would like to suggest to you. Number one, if you don't know many surahs, then grab the Quran or grab your phone on a Quran app. Hold it with you in your prayer if you can read the Arabic, and read from the Quran as long as you want, as many rak'ahs as you wish. If you don't know how to read from the Quran, then if you have memorized short surahs, even if it's just Qul Huwallahu Ahad, then you can repeat that surah over and over and over again as long as you like. And there is ample evidence in the Quran and Sunnah. Number three, if you don't memorize even a small surah and all you know is Al-Fatiha, then you can even just recite Al-Fatiha and make your ruku' long and your sujood long, and you can pray as many rak'ahs as you like, according to the majority of the scholars. Number four is for people who don't know how to recite the Fatiha at all. Let's say some people are still new to Islam or just repented and started their prayer and they don't know how to recite Al-Fatiha, then the scholars have agreed that you can put earphones and listen to a sheikh recite while you repeat after the sheikh. I'm not saying you let the Shaykh recite, I'm saying you hear someone reciting slowly and you can repeat after them while the headphones are in your ear. But even some scholars said, such as Ibn Jibreen, he said you don't even have to recite Al-Fatiha if you are not able to until you're able to memorize it. So my brothers and sisters, there are so many options for night prayer and Taraweeh, and it's all easy inshaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the sweetness of night prayer and the sweetness of feeling that love towards Allah. Ramadan Mubarak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and preserve you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.